Hey guys, welcome to the Android Development Tutorial Series by Geeks for Geeks. My name is Sriram and in this tutorial series, I'm gonna take you guys from the basics to a stage where you can get a job as a junior Android developer. So before we start this series, I just wanna tell you guys that you should know Java for this. There is a Java prerequisite for this course. If you guys don't know Java, I'll link to some videos in the description notes below. Go learn Java. You don't need to know a lot of Java. You just need to know basic programming, like what is an int, what is in float, what is a string, what is characters, okay, what's an array, for loops, if loop, while loops, functions, and classes. That's all you need to know. Okay, you don't need to know threading. You don't need to know all those advanced concepts that I'll cover here. All you need to know is the basic until like looping and functions, classes, objects, the object-oriented programming paradigms, the encapsulation, all those, you need to know that. So if you don't know that, I highly recommend you to go check out the links. I'll post a lot of links in the description notes. Go learn Java for a little bit and then come back to this tutorial series. All right. So if you guys know Java, let's get started. And here, I'm not going to show you how to install Android Studio. I'm not going to show you how to install the JDK and JRE. So I'll link that because there are lots of tutorials for this online and it's very simple. It's not, you just need to install the exe double click and then it's done. So I'll link to some videos in the description notes below. Go see how to install, and once you install the software development kit or the SDK, you will get this screen, okay, where you can see start a new Android Studio project, open an existing project and all. So once you come to the screen, come back to this video and then we'll start. Don't worry if you don't see a list of LS here. This is the list of projects that I've been doing. So since this is a fresh installation for you guys, you won't be able to see. Okay. So once you come to the screen, click on start a new Android Studio project. This is your first step for any project. You have to start a project in the Android Studio. Okay. Android Studio is based on IntelliJ, IDEA, Java, development environment created by IntelliJ. This is modified by Google for us to develop Android easily. Okay, so click on start a new Android Studio project. It looked pretty much the same either if you're in Linux or Windows or Mac, it doesn't matter. This screen will look pretty much the same, right? So every screen, for that matter, every screen in Android Studio will look pretty much the same, right? So click start a new Android Studio project. Okay, in this screen, let's look at the screen. So we have the application name. The application name is going to be the name of our application. Suppose you were creating WhatsApp, so WhatsApp will be the application name, or Facebook is the application name. So whatever name you see in the Google Play Store when you install it, right? So that is your application name. So I will keep my application name as my first app. You know, just keep it simple. One thing you should remember is this first character should always be caps. All right, if you try to put it in small, you know, Android will give you a warning. The application name for most are begin uppercase letter. All right, so sorry, have a capital M. Company domain. You might be asking, why should I give a domain? You know what a domain is, just a website you have that you own. You might be asking, why do I need to give a company domain? The thing is, see, I can develop an app called WhatsApp. You can develop an app called WhatsApp. The billion people on online can develop an app called WhatsApp. How will Google Play differentiate from your app and my app? All right, suppose I'm creating an app called My First App. You're also creating an app called My First App. How will Google Play differentiate? So every app has a unique package name, as you can see down here. Every app has a unique package name. All right, so that package name is created with the company domain name and your application name. We 99.9% we have our company domain name is unique, right? So suppose if I own google.com, no one else can own google.com. That is mine forever, right? So if I own sriram.com, that's mine. Don't try to go in here, there's nothing here. Okay, if you don't have a company domain, just have like your name.com, something like that. Make sure it's not there. Make sure there is no domain in that name online and then use it. Okay, so project location. This is a location where the project files will be there. Okay, so for now leave it at default. It's gonna be, if you're in Windows, it's gonna be in my documents and then a folder. For in my Mac, I've configured for a special directory. Okay, include C++ and Kotlin support. And we can develop Android apps with C++ and Kotlin. Kotlin is a language which came about recently, and I'll have a tutorial for that later on. So first, let's concentrate on Java. Then I'll tell you how C++ and Kotlin will be used in this development. Okay. So once you fill all this details, click on next. All right. Click on next. Okay. This screen is to choose what kind of development are you doing. So see. You can either develop for phone and tablets, for Android, where there is the Android watches, the Android TV. Android Auto is the software that runs on cars. It's not there in India yet. Like I don't think there are any cars in India running on Android, but there are some cars which have, you know, Android installed in their GPS system, and also, like, you know, you can ask for GPS and all those things. Android things are those IoT devices, right? So in this tutorial series, we're gonna stick with phone and tablets, but I might add, you know, develop for wear things later on. So right now we'll just concentrate on phones and tablets because that's the most common thing. You know how many phones of Android there are in the market, right? So we'll start with phones and tablets. In this drop-down menu, you have to select a minimum SDK version. SDK is software development kit. The minimum SDK version, suppose you choose Android 4.4 KitKat, right? So any phone from KitKat and above will only be able to install your app from the Play Store. Any phone below 4.0, Gingerbread, all those, they won't be able to see this app, or they won't be able to install this app. Okay, so you might ask me, why develop for KitKat? Why not develop for Nougat or Oreo, the latest version? The thing is, Oreo released a couple of months ago, and if you click on Oreo, you'll see by targeting API 26 and later, your app will run on less than 1% of the devices. So there are very few devices. There are only the Nexus devices, and the OnePlus 5T has gotten Oreo until now. So if you target for Oreo, only those devices will be able to, you know, install your app. That's not what we need. So usually for now, people choose KitKat or Lollipop. I usually choose KitKat, because approximately 90% of the devices will run. You might ask, so suppose if you go lower, a lot of phones will get supported, right? So why not just start with Android 1 or 2? The thing is, Android pushed some features incrementally. Okay, so in order to use the latest features, you need to have a pretty decent version. So right now, Android 4.4 KitKat is that sweet spot where all the good features are supported. Right. Suppose you go to 2.2, you can't have fragments, you know, something I'll teach you later on, and you have all those stuff. So the sweet spot for now is Android 4.4 KitKat, and you can also see that approximately 90% devices. So if all the 90% devices install, you will have billions of downloads. All right, don't worry. Here you'll see include Android Instant App Support. We're not going to do Instant App Support right now. Instant App is something that was bought in Oreo. So basically, if you're having an app like Quora or Facebook, and you don't have the app on Android, but you were going through Google Chrome in your phone and you saw a link. So when you open the link, you'll be having a pretty decent version of the app, which will run directly without installing the app, just for that moment. So that is the instant app support. We're not gonna go through that now, we'll do that later. Okay, so choose phone and tablet, choose Android 4.4 KitKat, and then click on next. So here, right now click on empty activity and choose. Don't worry about all this, okay? Don't have no activity, have an empty activity. I'll tell you what an activity is, and then I'll explain you what all these are. So for now, choose empty activity, click next. All right, so the activity we created, have the name as main activity. Don't change anything in this for now. Don't worry if you don't understand anything here, I will explain to you in the next video, okay? So right now, just keep the activity name as main activity, the layout as such, all right? And then click on finish. So once you click on finish, then you'll see something as a Gradle build. Alright, don't worry about that. I'll all teach you. This episode is about just setting up your Android and then making sure it works. Okay? So, let the Gradle build run. Okay? It might, since you're starting your Android Studio for the first time, it may take a little while to run. It may take 5 minutes, it may take 10 minutes, depending on your laptop speed. Don't worry, just let it run. See, if you see here, you can see Gradle build running. Alright? So, just let it run. And you will know it is completed once there is no loading bar in the bottom part, okay? So once this loading bar is stopped, you will know that everything is done and you see. So here you know, here there is no loading bar anymore. So now you know that everything is done, you can start the development. Alright, so I'll come back like this. So this is the development, this is the area where we're going to develop our apps, okay? This is the area where we're gonna write our code, okay? This whole area, all right? And this is the area where we can navigate through different files, different Java classes. You know Java, so you basically you know what packages are, right? So this is the package. So we'll have a lot, as we go on, we'll have a lot of packages. We'll have a lot of files, okay? So this is where all the files are, and suppose we wanna open this layout file, we'll double click here and this will open. Alright, so thank you guys. This is all for the video. In the next video, we'll install the emulator and make a basic app run. Alright, so thank you and stay tuned for the next video.